Hey guys, welcome to this session by Intellipaat. In today's video, we'll be discussing the differences between Agile and Waterfall, both methodologies that are used to develop software. Okay, before we go ahead, please make sure that you subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any of our future updates. Okay, now let's take a quick glance at our agenda. First, we will talk about what exactly Agile is and what exactly Waterfall is. And then we will discuss the impact both of these methodologies have had in the industry. After which, we will go ahead and set a few parameters that we will use as criteria to compare both of them. And finally, we will conclude by deciding which one is better. Also guys, if you're looking for end-to-end training in Agile, we do provide the same. For any further details, check out the links given in the description below. Okay, now let's start the session. Okay guys, before we go ahead and compare both of these methodologies, let us first have an overview of what software development is. Now, we know software development is a very long and arduous process. Why? Because there are a lot of things you need to do when you're working with software and when you're especially developing software. There are multiple components. You need to take care of the deadline. You need to perform different analysis like risk analysis, cost analysis. You have to follow all the phases there are. You have to plan it out. You have to then develop it. You have to implement it, deploy it, and monitor it. Now, to make sure that you're able to develop a software properly and in time and efficiently, you need to follow a particular software development methodology. Now, there are multiple ones out there. Like, for example, you have waterfall model, you have spiral model, agile model, scrum, and lean. Now, these software development methodologies basically help to plan out the whole software development lifecycle. Now, each of these methodologies promote different things. And in this video, we'll be comparing the two methodologies that are waterfall model and agile model. So we will start off by discussing what exactly agile is. Now we know that agile is a software development methodology. So agile basically promotes shorter development life cycles. It makes sure that the life cycle of a particular software that is being produced is very short. And this is because it needs to make sure that the customer feedback is prioritized and the feedback is then used to make the changes in the next cycle. So if we looked at the cycle of Agile, we will see that there is planning, designing, developing, testing, deploying, reviewing, and launching. So this process keeps on repeating after receiving the feedback from the customer's end or the client's end. It may not be a B2C where you're only interacting with the customer. You may have a B2B where you have another business client and they give you a feedback. And once you receive that feedback, you make the changes accordingly and then plan ahead for the next sprint or the next development lifecycle. Even though you have very short-term development life cycles in Agile, you have multiple of them. And it keeps on continuing until the whole project is completely finished or the support for the project has been closed or shut down. So if we looked at the benefits of Agile, there are a few. Let's discuss them. So the first benefit is transparency. So this benefit is basically for the customer or the client. Now, if you have shorter term development life cycles and you always show your components to your customers and clients and you take the feedback from them, then the client and the customer know what's happening with your product or your service. And accordingly, they can tell you about the changes that they need. And this way, they are kept to date about what's happening. Since the life cycle in Agile is so short, developers can only develop a few things at a time. So in every sprint, a few things are developed and they're shown to the customer and they get the feedback. This way, the customer is kept up to date with what's happening with the whole project. Now, another benefit is predictable costs and schedule. So this comes towards the developer's end or the producer's end. When you're producing the software, you need to be able to predict the costs that are going to be indulged with the project. Now, if a project is going to take a long time to develop, then it's harder to predict the cost because the variables over time increase and they're unknown. With shorter time, you're able to predict the cost much more effectively and you're able to schedule all the tasks much more effectively. Then the next benefit is basically that it allows for change. Now we know that today's market is very fickle. The audience's demand changes from one thing to another and they keep on chasing new trends every other second. So to cope up with this change, you need to use a modern methodology like Agile, which allows you to change your direction or change the direction of your project as a whole. Since you have very short-term life cycles, you can change your goal very easily. And the last benefit we are going to talk about is that it improves the quality. It improves the quality by basically getting the feedback from the customer or the client and then making the changes. It improves the quality from the perspective of the customer. Since they are able to ask for changes and the developers are allowed to make those changes, the changes improve the quality of the product. All right, now let's discuss the next methodology. That is the waterfall methodology. What exactly is it? So the waterfall methodology is one of the earliest software development models ever created and put to practice. And it's also spilled on to other engineering products as well, and not just software engineering. Now, this type of software development model is basically used for the projects which are very small and for the projects where there are no uncertain requirements. So let's look at how it works. Quick info here, guys. If you're looking for end-to-end training in Agile, we do provide the same. For any further details, check out the links given in the description below. Now let's continue with the session. So in waterfall model, we have a model which acts like a waterfall. So we'll first start off with the phases. So the model basically consists of all the different phases through which one has to go through during the software development process. Now let's discuss them. So one of the first ones is requirements. So in this particular phase, an organization or whoever is using this model has to decide what are the requirements for the software they're going to develop. They have to look at all the different types of requirements. It's functional requirements, it's non-functional requirements, and they have to make sure that this particular idea, this idea of having the requirements is very clear. Because since this is a very long-term software development lifecycle, they need to be clear with the idea of what they're going to be developing and what are the different things or the requirements they need for this particular software. So they need to be clear about their requirements. Then comes the next phase in which they have to start designing it. That is basically creating the architecture, assigning, and then developing. And in the next phase comes implementation. In this particular phase, the design, the architecture of the whole software development is taken and implemented. The code is developed and the test scripts are written, etc., etc. And then comes testing. In the testing, all the test scripts are then ran on the code, or the testing happens with the particular software components that have been created. And then comes the deployment phase. In this particular phase, the particular application that has been developed is deployed onto a production environment, or on a testing environment, or on a staging environment. Then finally comes the maintenance phase, in which once your particular product has been deployed, it has to be monitored and maintained. Now, with this particular model, you can develop multiple components of the software simultaneously. Different teams can work on different components and at the same time while using the waterfall model. All right, now let's look at some of the benefits of waterfall model. So one of the benefits is that it's easy to manage. Since there are, you know, it's not a short-term life cycle, you already have everything planned out, it's very easy to manage it. Then you can see that it works very well for smaller projects, because with smaller projects, you have everything clearly defined. You know what are the requirements and the time period is very less. So waterfall model will work for you. And then another benefit is that it's clearly defined stages. Since the stages are so clearly defined, you can easily manage it and you can easily go ahead with following all of these phases or stages. And then you can see that it's very well documented. Since with waterfall model, you have only one software development life cycle, you document everything properly. You write down what are your requirements during the requirement phase. You talk about, you design your particular software architecture, you implement it, etc. So while you're doing all of it, you document every single aspect of it properly. So these are the advantages of waterfall model. Now let's look at the impact of all of these methodologies. So first we'll look at the impact of agile methodology. Now, since agile is used a lot, most of the companies these days are using agile. If not agile, they're using DevOps. But a lot of companies are making use of Agile. And some companies that have been established for a pretty long time have also been making use of it. As you can see, British Telecom or National Bank of Canada or Cisco or Lego, these companies have shifted from a traditional model like waterfall model onto Agile. And they have increased their profits to a new height after changing to Agile. Now we look at the impact of waterfall. So waterfall is one of the earliest methodologies we have come up with. So all the different older companies, like you have your Microsoft, IBM, HP, Cisco, these companies used to make full use of waterfall before. Now they've changed on to different methodologies, or they've changed to hybrid methodologies of waterfall and agile together, but they don't use waterfall alone. But there are some agencies, like government agencies, like Ministry of Defense, like DRDO in India and DOD in America, or ISRO or NASA. These kind of government agencies do not have to fight for their market. They have already established requirements which they have to follow, and they have to be followed in a very rigid manner. So in their case, waterfall model is still used. they do not have the requirement of using Agile. They don't have to keep on competing with other companies here and there. They're not part of the business market. They have a set goals and they just have to follow them. So that's why they still use them. If they don't use it, they use a hybrid version of it. Now let's see the comparison of Agile and Waterfall. Let's see what are the criteria we'll be using to compare both of them. So the first thing we'll be measuring them on is the life cycle. Then planning, then requirements, then progress, then team, then emphasis, and finally the goal of the methodology. Now let's look at all of them. So our first one is life cycle. As you can see, Agile has multiple shorter life cycles, whereas Waterfall has a very long one. And the benefit of having a shorter life cycle is very evident. You can have, you can adapt to the market, you have transparency with the customers, etc., etc. We saw all of it in the benefits of Agile. And with Waterfall model, you have a very long process. Even though it's very long, it has its own benefits. Whereas it's easily managed, and in places where you don't have to compete in the market, it's very useful. Now let's look at planning. With Agile, the planning is generally done for a very short term period. Since the life cycle is going to be very short, around 2 to 4 weeks, that's the development life cycle, the planning is also done very fast for this particular period. Whereas with Waterfall, the planning takes a long time because the product is going to be developed over a very long time. So in planning, Agile does it fast, whereas Waterfall takes a lot of time because it's going to be a very long development life cycle also. Then comes the requirements. If you're comparing the requirements of Agile and Waterfall, with Agile, all the requirements aren't clearly defined in the start because you're going ahead with one direction, but you don't exactly know what are your requirements. You only get to know your requirements over the development of your product. Whereas in Waterfall, you need to know, or you already know all the requirements clearly, that you have an end goal in your mind and you have all the necessary steps that need to be taken to achieve that end goal. Then progress. So to measure the progress in either of these, Waterfall or Agile, we can see that in Agile, you have the review of the progress every other day. Whereas with Waterfall, the progress is checked every other week. Because, you know, in Agile, it's a shorter development life cycle. That's why you need to check the progress every day. Whereas with Waterfall, it's a very long term. It can go to 2 months, 3 months, 6 months. So it's done every week. Okay, if you look at the team size, now if we talked about the teams and the governance of these teams, in Agile, you can see that all the teams are self-governing. Whereas in Waterfall, all the teams are governed by a single authority. So you can see that Agile teams are a little bit more independent, whereas the Waterfall teams will not be that independent. Then emphasis. In Agile, the focus is on delivering the end product and increasing the business profit, increasing the value of your business, and making sure that your customer is very satisfied. Whereas with the Waterfall model, the whole emphasis is on implementing the end goal. You know your requirements and you need to implement them. Whereas with Agile, it's for the customer satisfaction and increasing the business value. Then the end goal. What is the end goal of either of them? For Agile, the end goal is to deliver the product features in sprints to the consumer and customer. That is to increase the business value and to make sure the consumer or the customer is satisfied. Whereas in Waterfall, the aim is to deliver a complete product only once it has been completed and gone through all the phases to give the final polished product to whoever requires it. So these were the differences between Agile and Waterfall. Now, if you looked at which one is better, Agile or Waterfall, you could definitely say Agile in a lot of cases. But again, this is very scenario based. You may have to decide for yourself. If you have to choose between Agile or Waterfall, you first have to look at what kind of software will you be developing. Will you be developing a software where the market's need may change every time here and there, or the market or the audience may need to give you a feedback? If that's the case, you need to choose Agile. Or if you do not have any business profits in mind, if you're working with an NGO or if you're working with a government where only your requirements have to be established, then you can go ahead with Waterfall. As you can see, with government agencies like hospitals or defense departments, they do not have to satisfy anyone's needs. Like, at least they don't have to satisfy any customer's needs. Their main goal is to implement a very rigid and polished system that will help them to finish their task or complete their task. With DRDO or the Defense Department, it would be to make really good defense softwares. Whereas with the hospitals, it would be to make really good hospital softwares. This is not the same case with Agile. So you have to choose based on your requirements, which one is better, Agile or Waterfall. If you wanted to say it objectively, you can say Agile is better. But a lot of places, Agile and Waterfall are used in hybrid with each other. They're basically hybrid methodologies. Quick info here, guys. If you're looking for end-to-end training in Agile, we do provide the same. For any further details, check out the links given in the description below. Okay, guys, this brings us to the end of the session. If you have any queries, leave them in the comments below and we will get back to you at the earliest. Thank you for watching.